Before I get this video started, on Saturday, September 22nd, I'll be in Houston, Texas for a meet and greet party at the Houston North Central Target location. Be sure to check out the link in the description down below if you can make it or if you're interested. A few days ago, the official Minecraft Twitter tweeted out an announcement that many players have been looking forward to since the release of Minecraft Bedrock Edition itself. Even in its earliest forms, such as Pocket Edition and versions similar, players have waited patiently for the arrival for the ability to create, host, and run their own servers off of their own computers or another device. Since the Bedrock Edition's release, options for players have been extremely limited in that regard. While the Java Edition of the game has had this ability for an extremely long time, it seems almost insane that this didn't come with the release and popularization of the Bedrock Edition, or at least shortly after. However, in the case of many things, and definitely this, it's better late than never. In this video, we're going to talk about the newly released alpha version of Minecraft's newest server hosting software and see how it stacks up against the competition. So, without any further ado, let's go ahead and let's check this out. So, if you don't play Minecraft Java Edition much, you might be asking yourself, what does this mean and why does it matter? To put it simply, this is going to change Minecraft Bedrock Edition servers as we know it. For the longest time on Minecraft Java Edition, players have had massive amounts of options when it comes to servers. These options are usually with either server hosts, server to play on, or various other things. On the Java Edition of the game, potential for servers are near limitless. Being able to enable mods within the game for all players to utilize, having a large range of minigames, amongst a plethora of other abilities, Java Edition has been noted as the way to play with your friends in Minecraft as long as you're all on computers. With the rollout of Bedrock Edition servers, though, we may start to see a shift in that mentality. Servers that run dedicated 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, have always been a challenge for Bedrock users. You either, one, have to leave your device running your private world with your friends on it all times and hope the device doesn't go to sleep due to inactivity, or you have to buy a Realm server or reach out to a third-party host. Realms and third-party hosts have one major downside, though. They cost money. Some people would rather have a computer running a server for them 24/7, and before this, even though server hosting software like PocketMine has existed for quite a while now, having an official Mojang option is something that a lot of people have wanted for Bedrock Edition. This new implementation gives players the options necessary to run a server for their friends without having to shelf the cost of a host. But is this new option worth not having to pay for Realms or another host, which have been reliably stable options? So, is this option worth looking into? Honestly, yeah. If you have a good enough internet connection that can handle multiple incoming connections, you may want to consider this as an option for your private Minecraft server. This isn't like playing your regular Minecraft Bedrock Edition with your friends, though. This offers way more options to customize. Where Realms and regular Minecraft multiplayer are usually just load it up and play Minecraft, this has a few interesting pieces, namely being able to change structures, resource packs, behavior packs, and more. On top of that, an offline mode is noted as available, not requiring players to log into the game and play, giving players the ability to connect directly to the IP address, though I've had limited success with it so far. And speaking of players, where Realms on Bedrock Edition has either 2 or 10 player limits, depending on the version you paid for, this new server option has no listed limit. While you'll obviously run into more and more issues as more and more players join the server, as is expected, having the option to not cap it out is extremely welcome. And here's a few pieces of trivia. Because you know I had to check, no, there is no Farlands on these servers. That's probably because the server is hosted and ran with Windows 10 in mind, meaning that the host and PC Bedrock Edition more than likely have a similar codebase. Another notable thing is a small bug that I found. Loading up the server and attempting to play on the same computer as the server was hosted on didn't allow me to connect to the game at all, but loading the server up on my laptop, however, allowed me to connect immediately from my main desktop. None of the bugs bugs that I found were inherently major, but it sort of felt like I was playing on Realms doing it that way. So far, I've seen nothing but potential for this new server option. Having to not pay for Realms, being able to change behavior packs, resource packs, and things of the like, and so much more really gives me hope for the server hosting software. Heck, with how much implementation they're offering here with just the alpha, I wouldn't be surprised if the future modding API would have built-in support in this regard. In its current state, for an alpha, this is great. This feels more like a beta than it does an alpha. It's extremely smooth, almost exactly like playing on Realms or general Minecraft multiplayer, but with more options at my fingertips. Given the fact that I wasn't about to put out my IP address on the internet for the first impressions video for everybody to connect to, my stability test was to detonate a large chunk of TNT, maybe about 10,000 TNT to be exact, multiple times. All things considered, it handled it pretty well. Whether these servers compare in stability to Pocket Mine or anything else remains to be determined in its current state, but this is an extremely strong start. But what do you think? Are you personally excited for the release of a new way to run servers on Minecraft Bedrock Edition? Is it about time? Do you think that Bedrock Edition will ever overtake Java Edition, even if it takes years? Let me know in the comments section down below. Also, more videos on the subject will probably be coming out in the near future whenever we receive more updates or find out more about this alpha, so let me know if you're excited for that. But other than that, that just about does it for me for now. If you guys enjoyed this video, please consider leaving a like on it, because it would really help out myself and Michael McChill, who co-wrote and edited this video, the channel, and the video quite a lot. But anyways guys, I hope you all enjoyed. My name is Ant Venom, and I bid you all farewell. Thanks so much for watching.